Hello, welcome to Lesson 8 of the course Introduction to Rapid Application Development using SQL Server and ASP.NET Maker. I am Benjamin Fadino. In this lesson, we are going to learn how to apply the primary key property to the account type ID column in the account types table. First of all, I'm going to ensure that my SQL Server service is running. Okay, it is running. And I'm going to connect to Management Studio. So I'm going to connect using the instance called Ibukunoluwa, and I'm going to connect using Windows Authentication. So I click Connect. Okay, I'm going to expand the databases folder, expand Wikibank DB, and expand my tables. So I right click on Account Types table, then I'll click Design. Like I said earlier on, I'm going to set primary key property on account type ID column. But before we do that, I need to explain what a primary key property does by giving two examples. The first example I'm going to use is that of university students. Every university student has a matric number in a university. And in a particular university, the matric number of a student is unique to him or her. Those two students in the same university have the same matric number. So when student data is being stored in the database, their matric number can serve as a primary key. Now the second example I'm going to use is that of bank accounts. Now bank accounts have a property called account number. Now, in a particular bank, no two customers have the same account number. The account number for the customer of the same bank is different for each customer. The account numbers are unique. For bank X, no two customers in bank X have the same account number. So, since no two customers of a particular bank have the same account number, so the account number can serve as primary key. What primary key columns do is that they ensure the uniqueness of rows that we store in a database table. Setting a primary key helps us later when we need to search for records or rows stored in a database table. It becomes easier for us to locate rows that are stored in a database table when they have a primary key defined on them. So having explained the concept of primary key, I'm now going to explain how to set primary key column. We want to set the primary key property on account type ID column. So the first thing we'll do is that we'll select the column. After selecting the column, we'll now right click on the column and then we click on set primary key. That's it. After setting the primary key property on account type ID column, the next thing we are going to do is we'll go to file, then we click on save account types. Note that in this tutorial, I've just set a primary key property on a single column. It is possible for one to set primary key property on more than one column in a database. That type of primary key is called a composite key. But we'll not be looking at composite keys in this course. Thank you.